This is the config file I came up with in order to get Sway working on Guix. If all you want is a working desktop using Guix and Sway, I uploaded the file onto my GitLab. Well, if you're interested in learning how I actually made this, I'm going to be spending the rest of the video going over that. When I first started using Guix, I had a lot of difficulty coming up with my own custom config. I spent a lot of time doing trial and error until I finally got something that worked. My hope is that this video will kind of go over a little bit of my trial and error process, so if you decide you want to do something similar, you know a little bit about what to do. Guix is really interesting because the entire operating system is declared in a single scheme file, and then you feed that into the Guix package manager. A lot of it is pretty self-explanatory, but we're going to break it up into little sections. In this config file, we have two use module declarations: use modules itself and use package modules. The difference between the two is that use module is the more general form of the declaration, while use package module is specifically for packages. I could technically include all the use package modules underneath the use module declaration, but that would involve me typing out GNU package followed by the package module I wanted to use. I'll talk a little bit more about what that actually means once we get to the package declaration, but first let's dive into the operating system. Underneath the operating system declaration, we have the stuff that you would typically expect. We have the hostname. In this case, I named it Guix Sway. You can name it whatever you want, though. We have the time zone. I set it to my time zone. And we have the locale, which I'm pretty sure a lot of people that are watching, there's going to be using UTF-8. Next up, we have the bootloader configuration. Guix provides a lot of different bootloaders to choose from, namely Grub, U-Boot, EXT Linux, and then one more, which for right now is escaping me. You declare which bootloader you want. I'm using the Grub bootloader. The target, in this case, is going to be the first hard drive that it finds. And then we also have timeout. The timeout refers to how long Grub is going to take before it boots into the first option that it sees. The default is around 5 seconds, and that's a bit long for me, so I like to change it to around 3 seconds. Underneath bootloader, we have the file systems. You'll notice we have a scheme procedure there in the form of cons. To kind of explain what that means, it's kind of similar to concatenate. In this case, we have the file system, and then it's going to concatenate in front of it the list base file systems. I'll explain base file systems in a bit. First, file system, we have the device that's going to be uploaded onto, which in this case is the first partition on the first hard drive, the mount point, which is going to be the root, and then the file system that we made our partition. Guix provides a lot of different file systems, including ButterFS if you want to use that, but I'm just sticking with something really simple. Underneath file system, we have base file systems, and it has a little percentage sign in front of it. What that means is that base file systems is a list of packages that you're substituting with this much shorter declaration. I don't have a full list of what's included in the base file systems list. You can find that on the Guix manual, but just know that it includes a lot of the more common file system packages that you would expect in a normal distribution like Debian. Moving forward, we have the users. We got cons again. If you're going to be using multiple users, you can't really use cons. You're going to have to use something like append list. Cons is a little bit faster than append list, which is why I prefer to use it. And in this case, I can because I'm only having two options, which is user account and the list based user accounts. In the case of this user account, you're going to need to provide a name. I don't have a name written. I'm going to put in my name, but for you, you're going to put in whatever name you want. It's going to belong to the group users, and it's going to belong to the supplementary groups. Supplementary groups would include stuff like wheel, which gives the user in question access to the sudo program. And then audio, video, and CD-ROM includes all the other software that is underneath that supplementary group. After that, we have base user accounts. Again, you can find a list of what packages are included in that list on the Guix website on their manual. Next up, we get into something that's a little bit more complicated. We get the package declaration. And this is the part where I would struggle the most with when I was first making a Guix config. You see, in order for Guix to install the default packages, you need to provide a corresponding package module that the package is located in. For example, Sway, Sway Background, Sway Idle, and Sway Lock are all located within the WM package module. Hence why we included that at the beginning. BMenu is located within xdisorg, Vim is located within Vim, Ranger is located within disk, Termite within terminals, LuaKit within web browsers, YouTube DL and MPV are located within video, NSS certs is located within certs, and Git is located within version control. Finally, we got base packages, which is another list of packages that you would typically find in a normal operating system. Services is where it starts to get a little bit interesting. We see that the service that we are using is the list desktop services, but we have this procedure that we're feeding it through, which is called remove. What remove does is we're telling it in this desktop services declaration, we want to remove the service GDM service type. GDM service type is a login manager that's included by default within that service. The reason why we're removing GDM service type from the desktop services declaration is because according to the Guix manual, GDM service type isn't able to launch a Wayland session, which is a little bit weird because I believe GNOME uses GDM, but whatever. According to the manual, they recommend using SDDM service type, but the issue that I was having was whenever I tried to launch SDDM, it always crashed. So we're just going to eschew that altogether and just not have a login manager because login managers are bloat or something. So what this is essentially doing is removing GDM service type from the desktop services, but leaving everything else. So when we boot into our operating system, we're just going to be confronted with a terminal login. And that's all we have for our services. Last thing we have on our Guix Config is name service switch. To be honest with you, I'm not really sure what this does. I see it included in a lot of default Guix Configs. When I first installed Guix, I didn't include this, but I'm including it here just for the sake of including it. It's up to you whether or not you want to remove it. And that's it. That's our entire Guix config. Now that we got everything, let's go on to actually installing it. Okay, it's finally time. We have our config file ready. Now we're going to install our Guix operating system onto a hard drive. I'm using this SSD connected to my laptop via SATA to USB connector. One of the really cool things about Guix is that you don't need to use the system distribution in order to use all the cool features that Guix entails. You can install Guix onto an already existing distribution. In my case, I'm using Trisco, but I can still use the same Guix commands that would initiate a Guix system on this laptop. I have the Guix config saved on this computer as guix-sway-config.sam, so it's right there. And I currently have this hard drive mounted onto the mount directory. And so the command that we need to issue Guix to initiate our config file onto our hard drive is Guix system init. The name of our Guix config, in this case, it's guix-sway-config.sam. And the directory that the hard drive is mounted onto. In this case, it's mount. You're also going to need root privileges to be able to enact it, so we use sudo. So the full command is sudo guix system init, name of the config, guix-sway-config.sam, and the name of the directory, mount. And now we run it. So we're going to let it run, and once it's done, we'll come back and we'll take this hard drive and actually put it into a laptop, see how it runs. Okay, and we're back. And it looks like it successfully installed the bootloader onto the hard drive. So what I'm gonna do now, I'm just gonna unmount this hard disk from the mount directory. And I'm just gonna take the SSD. Oh, there we go. So we're gonna take this SSD, should have the operating system initiated on it now. And what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna take this SSD and install it onto that T60 over there. So let's just hop right to it, see if it works. Okay, so I have the hard drive installed onto this laptop right here. It's my wonderful, beautiful LibreBooted T60. Let's boot up into the operating system and see if it works. Beautiful, so we're at the grub screen. It's loading up right now. So the idea based off the original config is that once it's done, we are just presented with a login screen. Oh, it's being all fuzzy right there. So now that we know that Guix is up and running, it's working perfectly fine. The first thing that we need to do is set a password for the user that we defined. So I'm gonna log in as root real quick. Root doesn't have a password, so you're also gonna wanna set the password for root as well, but I'm just gonna feed the name that I used as the username. All right, since we have our user set up now, I'm just going to log in. and we can launch Sway by typing in Sway. Now this works just fine, but the issue with the default installation of Sway on Guix is that it doesn't provide you a config file. So we're gonna need to copy over the config file from the GNU store into our .config directory before we can actually do anything. And I'm gonna show you how to do that right now. The first thing you're gonna need to do is we're gonna make a directory within our .config directory called Sway. That's where we're gonna store our config file. The config file for Sway is located within the GNU store, and we can check where it is by typing in ls/gnu/store/, and then *sway*/. Once we know where the config file is within the GNU store, we just cat it. Then you can open it from there and make all the edits that you need. For example, you can change the modifier key to Alt. And once you make all the necessary changes, you're good to go. You got a working Sway config. Anyway, I hope this was helpful, and I hope you all take care.